a nigga with his rapping ass. Blow a stack for your niggas with your trapping ass. Clap for a nigga with his rapping ass. Blow a stack for your niggas with your trapping ass. Time for. Time for. Time for. Coming up, coming down. Ride clean, fix your hair in my crown. Bad bitch, H-Town. Keep it trill, y'all know y'all can fuck around. Paris, where we been? Part my Parisian. It's whole time and no time. It's fuck all y'all season. Piss Bordeaux and Burgundies. Flush out a Riesling. When hoes out, them hoes out. Y'all put y'all weaves in and clap for a nigga with his rapping ass. Blow a stack for your niggas with your trapping ass. Spent all my euros on tuxes and weird clothes. I party with weirdos. Yeah ho, yeah ho. Don't pop Molly, I rock. Time for international, bring back the Concord. Numbers don't lie, check the scoreboard. Time for.
I'm the first one.
Welcome to Just Jokes Radio. I'm your host, Niki Moore.
I don't want you.
And I have sound in one ear, Foster. Welcome. We're here. We all here. Gang's all here. We got our newest hot diva.
Ain't she
Coffee, Roshan, Coffee Ferg.
Ain't she pretty?
Hey, baby.
I love myself a hot cup of coffee.
Yeah. Yes. Mocha.
I'll take a cold cup.
Uh-huh. Isn't that a cappuccino?
Black coffee, all sugar, no sugar and cream.
Sugar, cream,
yes,
no
that's
cream,
the kind of girl I want low, down for my team.
Whatever.
You know something special anytime Michael wants some of this coffee.
Yeah. I'm a
Michael want to taste like some of that coffee.
Look, a couple of weeks ago I was saying, she's all right.
Yes.
I changed my mind.
Yeah. Michael, changed Mark, my mind.
Jesus.
Michael, I do that.
You can Jesus, do that.
Yeah,
I can see how you do it.
That's the share. Just share yours. You didn't get it?
No, she
didn't
share
get a coffee.
One. She can share this one.
What's up, guys? What's been going on?
It
seems like it's been longer than a week since we've been together.
That's because a week ago, we were together twice a week because of the show. So we spent more time
here
together last week.
Yeah. I miss Foster. Week. That's what it was. It's been two
Foster,
weeks since
don't
we
you
Foster.
Ever leave us.
And it seems like it's been so much
I'll
longer.
I'll do my best not to.
Tell Foster, go. I only have sound in one earphone.
I know.
Foster.
I'm aware. It's a problem with the actual headphone box.
Well, can't we fucking get a replacement?
We are. It's
how
in the
much
mail.
Does a replacement cost, Boom? What the fuck? Okay.
Well, I can have him call.
Okay.
That's my weekly rant.
Hey, look, I have an idea. I just had an idea. From there on, I think what we need to do is, wherever Foster is, we find that bastard on the day that he can't come here, and we do the show from wherever he is.
So if you
so when
wedding,
you go to your sister's wedding, right. we're coming in there, buddy. We're gonna set
bed.
Up in the back of the church.
I can't wait to explain why there's black people in the back of my sister's
no,
wedding.
Black people cursing.
In suburban
and saying
New
all
Jersey.
Sort of lewd and lascivious things.
Just tell them Tom Ford.
They're
on
just
pop Molly, I rock Tom Ford.
That's all you got.
Yeah.
Down, 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 down.
Hey, so what do you think about the guy that your sister's married?
Nigga, nigga, nigga. That's what you play as soon as you walk in. That's exactly what you play.
Look, Boss is getting it all out.
I wish you people could see this.
Like, I just need to say one thing to you. Just one thing. I don't know.
Foster, you are my nigga.
That sounds like those school officials.
that was gangster rap.
You didn't find
name.
It?
I got it.
Okay, listen, we got a funny story. We're going to get right to it. So we have a hilarious story, Michael, about speaking of nigga, 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 nigga. I mean, stupid funny to me. I'm sure it's offensive to most.
Well, you know, there's this small town in western Pennsylvania, and there are these two school officials who are using school phones to communicate to each other. And basically what they were doing was sending racist texts. So we have a picture of the two guys, if Foster, if you want to put that up.
Don't have one.
But one of the guys is Superintendent Richard Como. And obviously he's the superintendent of the schools. And he's also talking to the director of activities named Jim Donato. Now, Jim Donato is the one with the kind of funny looking face. Yeah.
That's a JPEG issue.
Right, right, right. But somehow they felt privileged enough to just be able to just call people a bunch of niggas using text messages. So here is some of their rant last June.
Wait, what the fuck?
What the fuck?
So he's just like...
So give us some of the rants.
Okay.
I'm curious.
So.
A week.
Yeah,
Foster.
Wait a minute. You know, I wasn't supposed to bust out laughing before I started.
Go ahead, Michael. Okay, wait. Let's let him say it and dig this thing. Okay, now here's what they said. Go ahead.
All should just have whatever first names they want, then the last name nigger. So Donato wrote to Como, Leroy nigger, Preacher nigger, Night Train nigger, Clarence nigger, LaTanya nigger, Thelma nigger, and so on. Now, Como's response was, great idea. Joe nigger, Bill nigger, Snake nigger. That one got a nice ring to it. Then they continue on, and then they say, they're laughing back and forth at each other, and they'll say, like, let's say somebody's called into the office. Will the nigga report to the office? Pardon the interpretation, but will nigga report to the nurse's office? Nigga to lunch now. So then they say on June 7th, the pair exchanged another round of text messages, basically doing the same thing. Jesus Christ, can't get much better. Donato replied, blood and water, when they got a text that said, man, some week for sure, we'll be tapped Tuesday night by Delta versus Ritter, Campbell fight over drum financial claim, and sneak attacking wings. I have no idea what the hell
so
that means.
So basically, this guy, these two guys, one was the superintendent of schools,
yes.
And the other was the head of athletics.
Correct.
And this was a text on school equipment, telephone equipment between each other.
June, I mean, of last year.
Realistically, to me, it's fucking hilarious. But I mean, I guess
gold.
It's, you said what?
Gold.
It's funny.
I enjoyed it.
I mean, it's funny, but I know that it's offensive. At the same time, but the shit was funny.
I mean, literally, it's hysterical.
Okay,
I mean,
this is what I want to know. Who busted them? I mean, how did they get caught?
Well, what happened was because these are company phones, somehow they got access to the records, and someone does a review of the text messages.
You know, I'm surprised at that because generally you can't trace text, right? Isn't that right, Foster?
Trace text?
Like, there's no way to document or track text messages.
Oh, no, there totally is.
Yeah.
Okay. There's company equipment.
Especially, you can get text messages from your cell phone carrier. Especially if you have kids and you want to see what they're texting, you can request that from your cell phone carrier.
But you have to have it set up, so they must have it set up.
Well, I mean, it makes sense because...
Like, I can't go back and get prior texts.
Yes,
I can. You
can. I can see a whole conversation.
Yes, you can.
Okay.
Anything that's sent over the air, you can retrieve it.
Wow.
Okay, but so most likely these guys are going to be fired.
Well, they're fired.
Oh, they resigned in August.
Mm-hmm. Well, you know, I think we are getting too damn sensitive.
How many niggas you think ran to the principal's office when they said this shit over the intercom? It was just like a standard.
Well, they didn't say it over the intercom.
They just texted. They were texting between each other.
That'd have been hilarious.
They didn't say it out. They didn't dare say it out.
But that was the superintendent. Like, okay, imagine if your son was little Leroy was going to school.
Leroy nigga.
Little Leroy was going to school where the superintendent saw him and thought to himself, Leroy, hey, little Leroy nigga.
He not going to say, Leroy nigga.
No nigga.
Right? No nigga.
Most Leroy's a little.
Latrina nigga.
So what state was this in?
Pennsylvania. Coffee Western Pennsylvania.
Oh, see, they have a special way of saying nigger.
Oh.
They don't say it.
How they say it? Nagger.
The nagger.
Nagger. Leroy nagger.
Leroy nagger.
Yeah. In Pennsylvania, like West Virginia?
Yeah.
And they will still hang you out there towards the mountains.
Well, in that case, it's not
I
too
I know
funny.
A few.
Right.
I mean, if it was just some, like, liberal white cats saying nigger in a joke. I mean, if it was some rednecks, it's offensive. I'm highly fucking offending you fucking rednecks.
Nigga. Well.
And so we all say at one time, what the fuck?
Okay, moving right along. We got the Vivacious Coffee here. Hey, Coffee, what's been up with you?
Nothing. How you doing, Lester?
I love the way you say how you doing.
Pull her mic over. Pull her mic over.
How you doing?
I need to move up. Lester, okay, rubbing
purse,
on my legs,
purse.
My thighs.
You're
making me a little nervous.
Oh. I'm getting ready in your mouth.
You weren't supposed to tell
I'm getting ready to fight Lester to death for that
Coffee.
Oh, it feel good. Yeah.
Coffee, remember the gay man's anthem.
Okay.
Eat the mic.
Okay.
Eat the mic.
Eat the mic.
Damn.
Seriously, just don't seriously. Smell the
seriously,
mic.
Lester, do you want to fight for the death for that seat? Like Spartan, Gladiator? I'm ready.
You don't stand
well, if
a chance.
Well, he dies,
fucking
I get
I'll weigh you by 100 pounds, I'm, you little
you
fucker.
Know what? Do you? I want to. I'll take all you out just to sit right there. Let's go.
Django!
Drop! Man, this shit here, nigga. This shit here, nigga.
I hope
this
y'all
shit, this the real shit here. This the real shit.
Going down, skinny boy.
Going down. Michael, so what's been going on with you?
Oh, my God. This has been one heck of a week. So I was out last night promoting the show that's coming up next month because it is going to be the best show. I can't tell you. I was talking to people about this show last night, and I was saying to them, look, if you buy tickets to the next Just Jokes USA production, and you don't find these two comedians funny, I will pay you your money back.
Yes.
So last night I was hanging out and playing cards and, you know, talking about the show and everything. And got one more of those goddamn DC tickets.
Fuck.
Okay, so why did I get a ticket?
Do they give those to you on the bus?
Yeah.
Yeah, but you got to get it off the windshield all
right.
When you get off the bus.
While the bus
like
is
a transfer.
Moving.
Okay. Right.
While the bus
it's
is
called
moving.
A transfer.
Oh, okay, I got it. All right.
Because I was parked too close to the thick white line with a cross.
Mm. Where were you?
I was on North Capitol and T.
Oh, okay.
I mean, that's a pretty nice neighborhood.
Yeah, but it was a lot of people out there, so, you know, it was ticket haven.
Preach, brother,
oh
preach.
Oh, my God.
Tell us all about it.
I hate those cops. I hate them. Now, who comes at 1 o'clock in the morning to get somebody a ticket?
The people who need a quota, meet their quota.
Oh, I hate them.
My
hate
dad, because he's a cop and he's a bitch.
Your dad?
Your dad's a bitch.
Oh, God. I went to a dark place. Sorry. Hey, Just Jokes Radio. All right.
What's your daddy's name?
News flash.
All right.
The cop's not your dad. I'm your dad. Motherfucker. I'm your father.
And I hate you.
Hey, I wanted to give a shout out this week. I was pretty sad this week. I want to give a shout out to the CEO of Nintendo. He passed away this week. His name was... Hiroshi Yamauchi, and I played Nintendo a lot as a kid, and Hiroshi, this is for you.
And like we give a fuck about him, like we give a fuck.
Do it again, Foster. Do it again. I want to play with my joystick one last time. Do it again.
Hey, while we sitting here,
and
I want to give a special. Can I give a special shout out? Hey, Foster, I can't hear myself with this mic. Okay, can you turn me up just a touch?
Deaf dude.
That's because you don't have on headphones.
And I can hear you fine.
No, You hear me?
Yeah.
You hear me?
Excellent.
Yeah. If you make a mistake, we'll let you know.
Okay. I'd like to shout out to Gail, Tracy, Francois, and Agnes. Hey, y'all.
Francois and Agnes. Who are they?
Agnes is real skinny broad.
Hey, Gail and Tracy, but who the fuck are Francois?
No, remember,
Agnes?
He shouted him out last
week. Yeah.
Francois Boubaye.
They're fucking Francois. Listeners, Niki.
Yeah. I remember you saying Francois.
Right, because we had
because of Delaney.
Right.
And Agnes.
Agnes?
Yes, Agnes.
Like,
they're all sitting around on the sofa.
Don't do it.
Agnes that lives next door to Dennis the Menace?
No, actually it's Bewitch.
Oh, Bewitch.
Yeah. But anyway, how y'all doing? And welcome to Just Jokes Radio. And
hey, we're guys.
Here, and I want all the rest of you fuckers to say hi to them too. Hey!
Hey! That was a dry
Agnes.
Attempt.
Hey, Francois, Agnes, Gail, and Tracy.
That could be like a drag queen name.
Francois.
No.
Agnes.
Francois, Agnes,
Gail,
Tracy.
Hold on, let's pick our drag names. Let's do that. Uh-oh. Your drag name is like the your first pet and the street you grew up on.
I don't want a drag name.
That's your porn star name. That's your porn
what's yours,
star
though?
Name.
You don't have one?
I don't like
Agnes.
Let me
tell you mine. Let me just tell pick you mine. One. What's yours?
Okay.
Gigi Waverly.
And you can see him performing on Saturday nights.
That works. What's yours?
I don't want one. Don't
what
need one.
What is your pet? First pet.
Oh, first pet was Duchess.
Duchess, and what street
and
did you
street
grow
you
up on?
What street did I go grow up on? Maxwell Drive.
Duchess
Maxwell. Fierce.
Mine is Bubba East Capitol Street.
Yours is what?
Bubble Butt East Capitol Street.
Bubble Butt East Capitol Street.
It's called Bubble Butt.
No, we named his name was Bubble.
What's
we named this backside Bubbles. That's what we named.
Yeah.
I ain't even had no pets.
What was your
this
first
backside.
Pet?
My first pet was Clyde.
And what street did you grow up on?
Virginia Avenue.
Clyde, Virginia.
That's like a dyke.
Good one, Lester.
Butch Queen.
They could not get a drag name out of that one.
Butch Queen realness.
I want to play.
Mine was Tabby Edgewood.
Oh, that's a drag queen name. That's a drag queen name.
That's cute.
Hey, look, you know.
That is your drag queen.
I'm white, but not invisible. I want to play, too.
Oh, yeah. What was yours?
Mine is a Bear Canterbury.
Lies!
Okay. I am dead serious.
Bear
you had
Canterbury.
A pet named Bear? A dog?
A dog, yeah.
Canterbury. Bear Canterbury. That's Butch Queen realness.
Yeah, that is. That is.
I'm going to put it in your bud.
Butch Queen realness, you molester.
Or Bear realness.
I think mine was the best.
Yes, it was.
Tabby Edgewood.
Actually, I like
Butch
Marks.
Queen
I like
Marks. Real
who
better.
Was Marks again?
What was it? Something Maxwell. What
Duchess.
Was it? Duchess Maxwell.
Yeah. That's pretty
yeah,
good.
That's, yeah.
giving,
that's queen.
That's giving queen dumb.
Duchess Maxwell.
You just
and
want. Just
Duchess
go ahead, just
Maxwell
queen
and Tabby Edgewood.
I'll take it.
Queen dumb. Tabby all is right. Kind of like the girl that goes
well,
to
we
the
got
store.
Some hot celebrity gossip today, y'all. Gotta get into it. It's so hot. It's locked up.
Yeah.
All right. Don't be fooled again. So, DMX was on.
Dr. Phil.
Yes, he was.
Dr. Phil lit into his ass.
Yes, he did.
Oh, yes.
But, DMX gave a nice little speech. And
what was
I think it was, it was touching. It was touching.
Did you cry?
Almost shed a tear for the guy. Because you got to realize, he went on there to talk about owing $1 million back in child support over financial problems, substance abuse. He even has 11 kids by
11.
Six different.
That's what Dr. Phil was talking
different
about.
Different women.
Yes.
So DMX said.
He had 11 kids by 12 different women.
And he got one on the way, by the way. I forgot. Sorry, I meant to mention that. He got one on the way. DMX.
What? Who is fucking him?
Yeah, who's having what? Sex with DMX?
So he's cracking what? Up. It has to be a crack.
Well, but let me say this. Shout out to everybody that's listening from Yonkers, just in case you have a computer by now. But DMX is kind of cute.
He's sexy as shit, but not cracking
way.
Up.
Not, I mean, if you saw him smoking crack, that would be different. But if you just saw him nice and cleaned up and everything, he's hot.
Yep.
Not right now.
Only a gay guy would say DMX.
Not right now.
This is what he says.
Well,
this is what he says, which I thought was kind of cool. He says, I just need people to look at me
is if I speak and know who I am, but what I say, not by what you see in the newspapers and not by what you read. You can tell a lot about a person by looking them in their
Why
eyes.
Why you trying to read it like you?
I thought he was going to do it in his DMX voice. He sounded like he was trying it.
No, I didn't.
Hey,
no,
that's old DMX.
Now that's hot.
That's old DMX.
That's hot. Yummy.
That's old DMX.
It's not like, hey, yo, I just need people to look
okay,
at me.
We get it.
That's how I speak.
That way the first time.
Yeah, we good. We good. That was Puppy Pal.
But
Puppy.
But what's so crazy about that is this guy poured his heart out and all that, and this is the same dude like a week ago was running butt ass naked through a hotel. What? Cut it out, you nutty nigga. Cut it the fuck out.
I'm just saying.
I think he's hot, but I not right too. Now. I'd be glad when he get himself together because so I love him it? Singing.
Shout out to you, girl.
Rapping.
Could he get it now?
Could DMX get it?
He could get it when I was a crack whore.
He could get it right now from your ass. Stop lying.
To him now. He's poor.
Hey, yo. Nigga, get them jaws up.
Look.
Get them jaws up, nigga. I'll come, nigga.
Like, look how skinny he is. Look at his legs. He look like a skeleton.
Nicky Ball. That's what he look like he's saying right now. Come here, Nicky Ball.
I would be laughing if I saw him.
I'm just saying, take the black piece of tape away and then let's see.
No, we all right. We good.
Oh, okay. Well, I'm just saying some of us.
Wish we could.
We might have a different opinion.
So he was just running neck through the
butt ball naked. Yeah. No reason.
I would have been like, come here, DMX. Come this way.
Come in my room, huh, Nikki?
Shrinkage. All right. Solange.
Solange tweets. Something is.
That's your.
Your vibrator's gone off.
Yeah.
Don't she tweet?
You keep it right by your titties, too.
She's tired of people playing black. Somebody help me with that one.
I can't.
She tweeted the other day, and this is what she tweeted. She tweeted, what she say? She says, it's just so fun to play black, huh? With like, da 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 da. You know how they do. Let's all dress up and play black today because that's the shit that's fun, like Six Flags. What she's saying is, I guess she's like, she's tired of these token, these white guys or white corporations having these token black people. And then saying they down for the cause just because they got maybe one or two people like her who comes and performs for these gigs that she gets paid bunch of bucks for. So I don't know what she meant because at the same time, she going to go to these corporations like her sister. You know what I'm saying? They do corporate gigs, right? Don't they? Niki Moore? Hello?
Where are the crickets?
Do you not understand what I'm saying? The woman does corporate gigs. And yet,
Foster fell asleep on that story.
Well, yeah. So let's go on.
Do you understand?
Thank you, Foster. But let's just go on to another celebrity who's ranting and complaining about how they're not being treated right.
There you go.
All right, let's look at Chris Brown.
Breezy.
Let's give him a little shout out just in case he's listening.
I fuck with Chris Brown. So he can't
too.
Do nothing wrong.
As a matter of fact, I got a negative
picture. No, Breezy wants state evidence on a motherfucker. I got to get
on who?
On Jay-Z.
What did he say?
Breezy says that everything he says gets blown out of proportion and everybody's jumping on him. But when Jay-Z does something, it's just brushed under the table. That's going state's evidence on
a little bit. You're right.
Yeah. But it's true.
So why didn't he have to? Why do you have to even bring Jay-Z in?
He's talking about that's going state's evidence. What the fuck are you talking about?
No, that's like when Kobe
we
got called. That's like
that at the meeting yesterday.
No, that's like turn the state's evidence. You have to actually tell something.
Man law.
You ain't saying shit. They don't get it.
They sold drugs a long time ago.
Nikki is just so outdated. She don't understand this. It's
man law.
You know, it's man law. A man don't bust out another man, you know.
Like when Kobe Bryant got caught, he says, oh, ain't nobody say nothing when Shaq got all these baby mamas and not all these cheating on these people. That's what Kobe did that. The same thing. Man law, don't you do it, Breezy.
That really should take us all the way to
stupid man talk.
It's not stupid. It is man law. What is it, 101, 102?
Yes. Speaking of man law.
Okay, we're sitting around at a meeting last
just
night.
Just tell the fucking story. It doesn't matter.
It already disgusts her.
It was stupid. And I'm just saying, just go into it. It doesn't even matter where it was coming.
Two-fifths of us have already decided
stupid
it's stupid.
Man yeah. talk. Here's your theme music. Go.
Hey, what was the story? What was that?
We were actually discussing.
I'll tell you.
Okay.
All men like easy. They don't really care what a woman looks like. They just like easy. Go.
Okay, the discussion was that Nikki's always calling some woman, oh, he slept with her, she's hideous. But I was telling her that men don't give a shit because women always say, oh, he fucked her and she don't look as good as I do. Men don't care. Men just like easy.
Easy.
Easy. If it's easy, we will do it.
Fuck it.
Fuck it.
Fuck it.
Fuck it.
I don't agree.
Me either, Nikki.
Yeah, because you are not men.
I have noticed. So there's a trend with women who are like, why did you have cheat on me with such an ugly woman? They're more focused on the looks of the woman than the actual reason why the guy cheated.
Exactly.
So basically, do you right, agree thank you. That men only want easy? They really don't care what a woman looks like. They just like easy?
In the middle of the night, 3 in the morning.
No. Is that your opinion?
It depends what she's offering.
Because if you're not getting that at home.
Exactly. I'm going to go to that.
Right. Okay, but that's only some God. Of the case. That's not.
So even if you are getting it at home, they're saying they just want easy.
Well, I don't even think they're thinking that far.
No,
I think the rest
go.
Of us are.
See. Here you go. Just listen. Let me
explain this for him, please.
You're at the
plane again.
Oh, God.
You're at the office.
At the office.
Everybody's gone.
Everybody's gone.
Wanda's there.
Wanda's
not a 10.
Mm-mm.
She's probably a 4.5.
Maybe a 3.
And maybe a 3.
Right.
Juan is laying in the middle of the floor, butt naked, playing with herself.
Ooh.
A man's going to say, do I go home and sit on the sofa and look at TV? Or, damn, do I bang old Wanda?
Old Wanda, watch out and keep the cameras rolling because this is about to be real.
And so here, there she is. Look at her. Okay. That is ugly and disgusting. But at 3 in the morning, laying in the middle of the floor, nobody else is answering the phone.
Lester, that sort of looked like your ex-wife.
Ooh.
Fuck you, Nikki. You're disgusting. You're a disgusting creature.
Yeah, I don't think I'd jump on that at 3 a.m. I'm
right,
sorry.
How many
Patron shots?
I can see Mark going there. I can see Mark going there.
That's an over-dramatization.
Oh, really?
That's an over-dramatization.
Whoa.
So there's a limit to your easy?
I'm saying no, but why you single me out? It was like 3 other dudes in here.
Oh, so you saying you wouldn't do it to her?
No, I wouldn't do it to her.
Oh, my God.
But... You know,
Lester.
See, that woman was a 0. Okay.
Hey, look.
Now my limit is
zeros get fucked.
Yeah, they do
all the time.
By Mark.
By Lester.
Listen. In the mathematical equation, a certain amount of zeros, or eventually equal up to maybe what is it? One negative one. Foster, help me out here, please. I'm fucking dying. All right.
Before your most recent come
fucking,
up,
fucking
if
dying.
You put all those bitches
help
together,
me the fuck
those
out.
Past bitches,
because these there motherfuckers
four.
Are killing. There we go. There we go. There we go. It'll equal up to that. It'll equal to that.
Look at them teeth.
Well,
before you go there, check us out. Since y'all want to say that, hey Foster, go to that picture with Michael Jordan, and this is gonna prove my point. And me and Les's point right now.
Right.
Go to that picture of Michael Jordan.
Because when Nikki first saw this picture, she said the girl was hideous.
Now, you see that? Mm-hmm. This girl right here is claiming that she now is the mother of Michael Jordan's child.
And I don't believe it.
Why couldn't you?
You
wouldn't think that Michael Jordan would fuck that?
No.
Why is this?
She looks
because
like
he's a fucking millionaire?
Why would he?
Because she's fucking easy!
Describe for me the scenario wherein Michael Jordan would fuck her.
Hey, Michael,
first
I'll suck
he
your dick.
Runs into
come on
her
in the back,
first.
Bitch.
And then second, why he chooses her above all of his options to sleep with her.
I actually thank you guys for putting us men so high up on your pedestal. Appreciate it.
Exactly.
Sure do.
Not all men.
Sure do. Thank you.
Not all
men. But at the end of the day.
Men do what men do. You know, it's been that way since the dawn of time.
Since Adam and Eve.
Women will see a woman with fake boobs, and the first thing that comes out, oh, they're not real. Well, men don't give a shit if they're real or not. Yeah, I mean, it's this man shit. I'm sorry.
Have you looked at fake titty before?
Yes.
How does it taste?
Well, it's two different types. Mm-hmm. It's the good boob job and the bad one.
Okay. I've been part of the bad boob job.
The bad ones are really hard.
They feel like gummy bears. Yeah. They feel like stale gummy bears.
Yeah. Oh, you too, Coffee. I apologize for not bringing this your way.
And your fingerprints were still in her breast. Oh. They were so hard. Oh.
Yes. It actually sounds better when Coffee tells a story.
Let Coffee talk about it.
How does it taste, Coffee?
Talk about it.
Nobody else.
Nobody else.
I just squeezed it, and my fingerprints was just... Yes.
Tell us more.
Actually, both of you guys do that again. That was a little turning me on right there.
But then it's the expensive boob job where it feels so natural. It's like unreal.
Like Dom Perignon.
That's where the saline. That's when they get the saline, not the silicone.
Is that
that's a saline implant. Those feel good. Silicone just get hard.
Yeah. The silicone are the ones where the bad silicone. Yeah. There's two different types of silicone also.
Oh, okay.
Yes. You can get the $20,000 boob job, mm-hmm. or you can get the $7,000.
Yeah.
$7,000 one where when you squeeze it, you know.
Why do you know how much they cost?
Man law.
I used to live in LA. I know the prices of plastic surgery.
Man law 2.
That makes sense.
112, is it, Lester?
Really?
Know how much boob jobs cost.
Yes.
It makes sense that he lived in LA.
And he knows how much
plastic. Yes.
You
know how inquisitive Foster is.
I will
about
find
everything.
Out this shit. Yeah. I mean, I dated a girl with fake titties and she told me how much they
Foster,
cost.
Foster's in the damn thing.
Asking questions.
What?
What are you doing?
It places the lotion in the basket.
Oh, she's saying you keep
she's doing
hostages,
the dramatization.
Oh.
It places the lotion in the basket.
Was that a queen?
That's like queen.
Yeah, queen. You know, queen.
Queen.
Clean.
Clean. Clean the dishes. You say queen because it's funny.
Yeah. I hate all of you.
I can see Foster up there doing that awkward double jointed pose that he does with his little pink man nipples showing. It plays with the lotion.
Fuck you with my pink man.
I'm scared.
Yes!
Mommy, yeah. I'm scared.
Horror.
Just say it, Foster. It places the lotion in the basket.
It places the lotion in the basket.
No.
Whoa.
Yay! Hey, we here at Just Jokes Radio. We have no cut cards. I mean, this shit is hilarious.
So we do know that there is one man.
Michael, your baby's crying.
And I'm not going home. We do know that there is one man who isn't. He doesn't like easy. That's perfect. He was on his way to his wedding. And because he didn't want to get married so badly, he took a pair of scissors and cut his testicles.
What?
He cut his testicles.
Do we have a picture of him?
We actually have a clip from the Huffington Post. I don't know if Foster can pull it up, but
we have him cutting off his testicles?
No.
But no.
No, we actually have the Huffington Post reporting it. Wow. Because
yeah, I'd like to see
there's very little information about it, and the fact that the Huffington Post would actually take the time to report this gives it a lot of validity.
Mm. Well, here's my thing.
Please.
Because
dude must really been desperate. I mean, it was like, wow. I really don't want to marry this bitch.
Right.
I got these scissors. What the fuck can I do? A ear? No. A nose? I'm going to cut these nuts off.
Make myself a unit.
Ugh. I'll show her.
I'll show her.
Baby, I can't make it.
Yeah, see? I'll be a unit here, see?
My
you
nuts
never
just
hear,
came
see?
Loose.
Well,
is he white?
We don't know. The worst part of
please,
the story
God.
Is...
You don't have a picture?
Well, all we have is the...
I'm looking.
The MP4 clip of the... Huffington Post talking about
oh,
it.
Oh, well, we don't want that.
Believe it or not, this guy goes to the emergency room. They delay the wedding. Somehow he gets patched up and then marries the woman.
Oh, God.
So he...
Loser.
He cuts his testicles and then marries the woman anyway.
I'll marry her anyway. I'll marry her anyway.
What? So what did she say?
That's some stupid man shit right there.
No, that's some dumb ass. His dumb ass. That nigga's dumb.
We're going to move on. That's disgusting.
That was the dumb, disgusting.
It was.
I want to talk about Oprah. I want to talk about Oprah telling Lindsay Lohan, you know, get it together. Or she can say goodbye to 2 million.
Well,
now, so how high? 2 billion.
2 million.
2 million.
2 million.
2 million.
So how high is Lindsay to, to turn this down?
I guess crack is coming back in Hollywood.
Heroin is making a huge comeback.
Huge. It's huge.
Yes, it's actually getting a lot bigger than it really should.
That's what's going on.
Yeah, and there's also a new drug called Crocodile. Have you heard about that coming out of Russia?
What
the fuck is that?
Cheap bathtub heroin.
Coming out of Russia?
Oh, yeah. It actually, people inject it into their skin and it rots away the flesh. And it hardens. The flesh hardens and it looks like crocodile scales.
Whoa.
And then it falls off and just reveals the bone.
Oh, my God.
So how does it make
you feel? Get some of that crocodile shit, cool.
Obviously good because people keep doing it.
And how much do you have to smoke, drink, take? In order for your skin to begin to fall off and dissolve. How much do you have to do?
Anything to get high.
Not that much, honestly.
Amazing.
Crocodile.
I know you got some of that crocodile shit, cuz. Well, I need that shit.
Depending on how much it costs, we might not see it in the black neighborhood. Because if it's expensive.
Oh, it's going to get cheap.
It's cheap. It's super cheap.
No, okay. See, they said that about meth. Right,
methamphetamine.
Yeah, you know, meth is cheap. It's gonna run rampant through the black.
I'm gonna post a picture that's very disgusting right now. So if you do not like gore, look away from your screen because here it comes.
Here we go.
And everybody watches the screen.
Boom!
Let me get you in that crocodile shit, cuz.
Is that the?
That's from crocodile.
My arm ain't fell off yet.
That's from injecting
into your
arm.
What is the yellow shit?
That's fuck the bone.
Pus and pus type of shit.
That is the bone.
That's disgusting.
Oh, that is so disgusting.
Is that real?
But
that's
how
real.
Is he holding There's, up his I've arm?
Do it again.
No, Nikki. Hey, fuck
I like that,
that
nigga.
Yeah,
I just can't believe
We'd
that.
Like to
that,
keep the rest.
I don't
want to
see it, but I can't look away. I like that, nigga. Show it again, please.
I am repulsed yet oddly interested.
Do it. Rock.
Here it comes again.
Girl, look
is
at
that
the
his bones?
Yes.
Yes.
That looks like a girl.
Oh, my God.
Or a very little man. Little
of course.
Boy.
That is just horrendous.
Woo. See where the bone is starting to rot also?
God.
That's nasty.
You sure amazing. That was crocodile?
Crocodile. That's what it causes.
Yikes.
I'm a source of information. What else would you like to know?
How in the hell does she like hold her arm up for him? You know, like it
there's
doesn't
muscles
hurt.
In your shoulder that
it
lift
looks
the
like
arm.
It hurts though.
I'm probably sure it does.
She don't give a shit, obviously.
Yeah, she's obviously
she's
high enough not
high.
To care.
I'm
yeah.
still like that.
But who takes a picture? Like that?
I was ugly. Yeah, I felt ugly. My lips dry and everything. I'm saying.
People get hooked on it. Usually die
oh
within
my
3 months.
Goodness.
And
oh,
once again, we all say at the same time.
Oh,
what the fuck?
But did you hear him say? He said people who normally do it, they die in 3 months. Done.
Yeah, because I mean, your flesh is rotting off and falling, so you're gonna die from that, from exposure, germs getting into you. Yeah, and
yes,
people who do it don't
just
live in
open
sanitary.
Like that with
oh
the
my
bone
god!
Yeah,
but I never
meat hanging.
I never thought that was. If you was gonna say that, humanly possible.
No, I was thinking. I never understood the thing with the bath salts, like people sniffing the bath salts and all that stuff. Like, because
it's illegal high.
Well, not just that it's illegal high, but basically you're taking all kinds of chemicals and ingesting them. It's got to be ripping your insides out.
Oh,
well,
yeah.
It has to be.
That's the same as
people snort
cigarettes.
Meth.
I think it's worse.
I know one thing is
it's
doing.
It's all kinds of chemicals in cigarettes.
Yeah, but I
hey,
mean.
Look, you know, I found in my travels that people will do anything to get high.
Yep.
You know.
Anytime you put acid on the top of your head to get high, I mean, I've seen people do it all.
Acid?
I thought she said ass.
She put acid on the top of her head. She did all that.
For what?
To get high. She said to just get you a real natural high.
Because it goes through your
like
scalp.
A real hot, yeah, like she said, it just wait it hit you real fast.
Jimmy Hendrix,
because my
so
brain
high.
Is getting
that
fried.
What kind of acid? I mean, like,
I don't know. I
like,
asked that. I
lysergic acid, diethylamide?
Like,
this
like,
nigga.
Yeah.
Like,
yeah.
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 What are you also a pharmacist? Yeah. Yes, he motherfucker?
No, but he is of that age where THC and acid and orange sunshine and all that other stuff was going on okay. when he was out there.
Well,
so
I was
he probably had
that.
And
I had them squib, the blotters, the paper thing.
Before right, but there were
that?
Like,
rookie
there was mom. All kind of stuff going on
rookie.
Then.
Rookie mom.
Trust me.
Go ahead.
There was so okay. much stuff going on then. Woo!
Yes.
So you heard about the acid too?
Well, it sounds like you're talking about like
hallucinogens.
Battery acid?
Mm. Yeah, but that would, I mean, that would
that
injure
would,
you.
Yeah, that would hurt. Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Wouldn't any
but,
acid
but they
hurt?
Did, I mean, it's kind of similar to skin popping in
no.
a way. If they cleared, but you have to
vinegar.
Have some kind
it's
of moisture
acid.
In order for the,
tastes
the
good
acid
on greens.
To break down.
Yep.
Because it's not going to break down quickly.
Vinegar's well, an acid, and we were saying it tastes good on greens.
Well,
Mark and I like to have our own conversations.
So much for that. I feel like I need to pick up a 24-hour chip. After all that shit, go to a 12-step meeting.
Oh, shit, man.
Any anonymous
I feel so dirty.
Go
is
hug.
AA available?
Hug somebody.
Niki, if you're feeling dirty, do you want to
oh, but anyway, I want to talk about something else right now also. I want to talk about the people that, Coffee, what's going on at the Coffees?
At Ripper. The Coffee Lane.
At the Coffee.
So at the Coffee.
We have,
coffee
we have lane. Shout out to our new listener from the Armed Services.
Ooh.
Niko.
Clap it up for him. Clap it up for him.
Is listening. I don't know where he is, but he said, good. How is that real if there's no blood?
See, that's why
Foster.
We need. That's
hey.
Why we need our soldiers.
He's seen a lot of wounds, too. You might have a point there.
Well, it did look nasty.
Well, it does
though.
Rot off. You don't really bleed from rotting flesh.
That's there's right. The same as gangrene.
Boom, white guy.
Gangrene, if it, yeah, the flesh just rots.
Yeah.
And there's no blood. Soldier boy.
Boom, we got a white guy on our team. Bow.
Niko, you keep those fucking
fact
smart
checker,
questions
motherfucker.
Coming.
And I'm still for you, Niko.
Get that gangster music in
yeah.
on him. Get that gangster music on him. I know what you about,
hey,
Foster.
Hey,
so,
Niko.
How about Detroit Mayor Kwame Kilpatrick's wife got caught stealing?
Stealing. Red fucking handed.
There's a video on the web. We're not going to show because it was kind of boring. But she had all the signs of. Like stealing because while they were searching her shit, she
was
she was
doing.
Doing all of this. She was like, look, stand in the middle of the office. Who does that?
Guilty
of a search of your desk. She's doing like this, rubbing her head. Like, bitch, are you fucking kidding me? What, so, like only the niggas steal Foster? Yeah. What the fuck was that?
That's exactly.
Nigga.
He's getting
why
a little happy with himself.
Why couldn't you give me some goddamn Led Zeppelin?
I think the Pennsylvania is coming
go?
Out in him.
I will pull out the
how
most
is
random
it,
shit on
how
you.
How is it that you give nigga when I'm talking about bitches stealing?
Hey.
Well, because he was talking about Pauline Kilpatrick.
So she's in Texas working at, what, an arena or something?
She works at an arena where they're collecting cash, right. like tickets. And she went and took some extra money right. and put it in her drawer, yeah. which she thought was very normal. But it seems that there's
well,
a policy.
She alludes to it as if it would
tell us
get
about
her
the policy.
Out.
Well, the policy says that if you have any kind of overage or underage, you have to report it immediately and turn it in. So on her way to making the report, I guess she just stopped at her desk and never left.
Well, the people call the cops, and the cops were standing in the corner while they search her desk to come up with the $312. Mm. Okay. Now, common sense would tell you that if your black husband was the mayor of Detroit, they're going to be watching everything you do because he's perceived as a thief. Who's married to a motherfucking thief. And so why would she even do that? And the policy clearly stated that all overages are to be reported and turned in.
That's correct.
Nigga, 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 nigga. Nigga, nigga,
oh,
nigga,
now
nigga,
you,
nigga.
Like only the nigga, nigga, the nigga, 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 nigga. So we got to be nigga, nigga, nigga when the goddamn bitch get caught stealing.
No. I ain't say nothing, but yeah. I just heard everything.
Give me that. Thank you.
I just heard everything the man just said.
That was some Geechee redneck shit. Thank you.
That was some Geechee redneck.
I have a feeling that if anybody from Detroit is listening, they probably, when they refer to Kwame Kilpatrick, would also
say... They don't
say,
have internets or radios left in Detroit.
Well, yes. It might be gone, too.
Yeah.
Only thing they have in Detroit are guns and bullets.
And Morris codes.
And they're counting those because bullets cost $989 per bullet. They ain't killing everybody. They doing that shit sparingly.
They're shooting the motherfucker and then go dig the bullet out.
You so know, somebody told a joke. That was D.L. Hughley, I think.
What is that?
Was it Chris Rock?
Chris Rock.
Yeah, why don't bullets cost how much?
No, he said if bullets cost a certain amount of money, it'd be a lot less more killers
right.
out here.
You want to talk about gun control, it's raise the price for bullets.
Yes.
Because the motherfucker be like, shit, I ain't wasting no bullets on him.
I would kill you right. if I could afford it. I'm going to get a job, get some overtime, save up my money.
After I get my 401k, I'm going to get me a bullet and kill
you.
You
dead, nigga.
Mm-hmm. How much are bullets? Anybody know how much?
Depends
a bullet?
On
Let's
the
ask
kind
Nico.
Of bullet you want.
They're cheap.
Let's ask who?
Nico, tell us how much are bullets?
Yeah, tell us how much bullets
yes,
are.
Yes, white man.
How do we know he's white?
Oh, I thought we were talking about Foster because he's going to boom out Nico. I'm not listening to Nico.
Nico's
Holy Foster's
fierce.
All my information. Hey,
Nico's fierce.
How much a bullet,
he's a
Nico?
Probably about $12
for
oh,
a box.
It's cheap as shit to shoot somebody.
No, how much is a gun?
About 13.
Couple hundred. Depends.
Well, evidently they can't cost too much because too many people are getting
right.
it.
And isn't there a gun for every person? There's like 300,000 guns. 300 million guns sold right now.
Yeah, a box of 45.
Well,
costs
as of Tuesday, I think the new law comes out in Maryland that, you know, to buy a gun, you got to get fingerprinted. So if you're a psycho and want to run up in the Navy Yard, you know, before you get the gun,
you're going to have to go to Virginia to pick it up.
Pretty much.
Okay.
I actually really want to go to a shooting range, to the NRA shooting range.
I've been to one.
How was it?
It was all right. It was kind of like a rush. I went like years ago, like
it's
before
such
my
a
daughter
stress
was born.
Reliever.
It was a rush. No, me and my buddies went.
Chuck and Billy's doesn't count.
Sweetie, before I met you, I had a lot. But no, you should. I all jokes aside, I really recommend it. It's a great stress reliever because I did it one time and it really relieves some of the
Shooting
stress.
Water guns is a stress reliever.
You can play if you want to, but I'm giving out some good information here, bitch.
Actually,
get it together. Know me.
I want to give a quick shout out to Butterfly over at Chuck and Billy's for saving my ass when my white ass walked in there looking for you guys. it was your birthday. You're gonna be at Coffee's. I didn't remember the place, so I walked into Chuck and Billy's in like a button-down shirt and my like shoulder strap. Yeah,
that is fucking hilarious.
And I'm walking in there and I'm like, I'm looking for some people. And they're like, oh, okay. They're probably thinking I'm a cop at this point. And my fucking white ass. So I'm walking in there and I'm looking around. There's just like two women at the bar and I'm turning around and walking out. And this woman's like, are you okay? Can I help you with anything?
You need some Titus.
I'm like, no, I was just looking for someone. I don't know what bar it is. I was just walking up and down. She's like, hold on, hold on. She ran to the back and like moisturized her hands. And then she came out and like took me by the hand and led me out of Chuck and Billy's. And I was like, oh, thank
that
you
is
so
funny
much.
As shit.
That's hilarious.
They will shoot
she
you
said,
in here, white
on,
boy.
Yeah.
Thank
on.
You, black lady.
I just wanted to save you, and I can go to heaven. I saved one white person in my lifetime.
And apparently,
I bet you won't play nigga, 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 nigga up there. I bet you won't do that. How about that?
Merry Christmas.
And Nikki, why you gotta keep
listen,
saying Merry Christmas?
Lester was telling me a story the other day about the reason he don't cheat on his wife. So he goes on into...
Because she's your wife, maybe?
No,
do tell.
He goes on into this whole long spiel about the shit gets complicated. He would feel guilty and all of this shit about the bitch. And and when he's trying to sneak a call in on the holidays, and when the bitches be calling, and he said, what she say?
Yeah, she called, Merry Christmas.
Oh, whispering God. That shit on the phone. Merry Christmas. Happy Thanksgiving. I just wanted to call
and say happy holidays.
He sounded like that old guy from Family Guy. You know, the old perv that lives next door that's always God. Talking about Chris. You got a strong chest.
Well, come to my basement and have some of my popsicles.
Come in my basement.
Get your I got some treat for you in my pocket. You just got to reach down in there.
Get your fat ass down.
I got some butter if you want to rub it on your body.
Having a side chick, I mean, is more awesome. Complicated. Then, I mean, you know, it's this complicated because I don't know about the rest of the guys, but I really feel guilty about, especially when the holidays come, you know, they're talking about, I'm home alone, I'm not doing anything, and it's Christmas, and I got this little, I got your gift.
I couldn't do it.
And then they call on that fucking phone, and you pick the phone up, you're running to the bathroom, the outside.
Baby, what's wrong? What's I have to shit, it's fine, I'll be back in a second.
Merry
Hello.
Christmas.
And then she door closes, gloom, yeah. Car engine, room.
I just wanted to say, Merry Christmas. That's why you're calling me.
And you know she wants to cuddle too. She wants to cuddle, not just have sex.
Yeah. Happy Thanksgiving.
I want the hell, then the hell deep.
The what?
You don't remember what was the movie? Shaft. Yeah. I want you want the hell or you want the hell deep. Remember when he was at the bar?
I remember now.
Yeah. Fuck Foss up.
I'll take this.
Foss, you don't have to go to Chuck and
Billy. Let me tell you what you're not going to do no more after this episode of Just Jokes Radio. Okay.
I got you, Foss. Don't worry.
Ass get ready, get
so
beat.
What's up? Look, Miley Cyrus.
Oh, my God.
Miss Miley is getting life, honey. Miss Miley is in everybody's dinner conversation. I just noticed on Jay-Z's album, he sang about Miley Cyrus twerking.
Yeah.
So Miss Miley is just she's doing it. But you think she's crazy like a fox?
Well, I mean, let's think about it. Is she crazy for doing some of the things that she's been doing in public, or is she crazy like a fox? As a result of this craziness that's going on, she actually has a number one video, over 15 million hits on this new video source called Vito. And for her to have not done anything for real since Hannah Montana and to come out with this new single and to get 15 million hits, that's badass.
And number one on Billboard charts. You know, Miley is like, I believe you, she's taking a page right out of Madonna's playbook.
That's right.
How to be disgusting and get famous.
Right.
And I ain't mad at her. You know, she's losing that little fan. She may... And if the parents say, Miley's a whore and I don't want you to watch her, those kids are going to run to watch that little bitch.
And here's the other thing that is surprising.
I thought I was going to say twerk it, but it didn't. It was a fucking news report.
Here's the other thing that's surprising. Miley can sing her butt off. I mean, she's doing all this craziness, but at the same time, she performed on VH1 Divas last year or something. And she...
Did she?
Oh, she has the chops.
Yeah, she can blow.
And she can dance.
I said, I'm not mad at you, flat girl with no butt and no titties.
She's like a little boy.
She'll actually be hosting SNL this Saturday.
That's right.
So she's coming up. She's coming up.
I bet you had to have a big ass.
Oh, I've already got it taped.
To twerk.
You don't watch SNL?
I twerk well. I beat Nikki at it.
I think you have to have a big ass in black neighborhoods. Because, okay. You know, we like ass.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? But, you know, for people that like easy and, you know.
White.
Well, I want to say all big asses can twerk.
You, yeah, because I was going to say the same thing.
All big asses can twerk.
Nick Gay. Twerk it.
No. Oh shit!
Foss, you gotta put on some twerk music.
Twerk it.
Hey, go ahead, put on Juicy J. Bands will make him dance. Let's see, can she twerk?
I got too much to be twerking.
I can't twerk.
You're too sick to twerk. I don't want a sick coffee twerk.
Be sophisticated twerk.
I'll be twerking all slow, like a old lady. Can't lift his butt cheek up.
Oh, we got two of them can't twerk. We got two big butts can't twerk. Too, not to be a song.
You just can't do it like the
two
young
big
girls.
Butts can't twerk.
But you can do it.
Two big butts can't twerk.
I'm a practice. I need to learn how to dance. Song.
You need to twerk.
Hey,
class.
Look, Niki is twerk deficient.
Yes. I'm not deficient.
You are Life Goes On to twerks. Remember that show, Life Goes On, with Corky, the retarded dude?
Uh-huh. Foster.
Oh, yeah.
Wow. There you go. Come on, Niki. Let's do it. Let's see it, Niki.
That's sad, Niki. Okay,
turn it up
loud. Showing us
up.
Come on,
Foster.
Hey, put that camera over that way.
Come on.
Yeah. Yeah.
Twerk, Niki.
Twerk, Niki. Twerk, Niki.
Twerk, Niki.
Twerk, Niki.
Twerk.
Yeah.
Twerk. Bubble. Twerk, Niki.
Twerk, Niki.
Yes, you will. Twerk, Niki.
Twerk, Niki. Do it, Niki.
Now she, look. Now she get ready to go to do a strip club number.
Yes, you will.
Did Niki, I do it? Did
Niki,
I twerk?
Niki, you were twerking one side of your ass.
All right, that's enough, baby. That's enough.
Did it work?
That's enough.
Did it work? Can I twerk?
Yes, you can twerk.
No, one side of your ass. One side
and
of your ass.
That looked lovely.
One side of your ass was
you
twerking.
You say.
Was I twerking?
Yeah. One you side say. Of your ass was
I felt
was
like
moving.
I was twerking.
You did. You were.
I'm twerk obsessed.
I actually was so shocked
that you were twerking. I couldn't get my phone together to tape it because it was amazing. I gotta give it to you. That was good. That was good.
Niki can twerk.
Yay.
My twerk. I'm so
the
mad at myself that
I gotta practice.
I'm so mad I got
now
the end of it.
Next week.
Fuck.
Okay, I'm gonna practice some more because I feel like I can twerk now.
Yes,
we're gonna have a twerk off next week. Oh my lord, twerk off, niggas. Speaking of twerking.
Yeah, bring that skinny ass now, Foster. Yeah.
No, no. Oh, we only have a few minutes left. We don't want to waste it.
All right, Michael, let's see what you can do, Michael.
Next week,
let's see your twerking.
Don't look. Don't play with me. Don't play with me.
No.
Don't play with me.
I will play with you.
Don't play with me. Not right now. Okay.
Oh, Lord.
All right. I'll take you on anytime, buddy.
Right now. Challenge.
You don't want
challenge.
It.
Yes.
Not from GG Waverly, you don't.
Oh. I'll wink at you all night until I get it. Yeah.
Hey, the other night, Niki and I were sitting outside of Coffee's
Coffee,
Lounge.
Coffee, they said you next. He said, really? He started laughing. What you laughing for? I twerked.
I got you. I'm going to twerk next week. I got practice.
Tune in.
Hey, well, look, we
and call all your friends.
We
and
tell them. Chicken noodle
it's
soup.
Twerking. We
it's about to go down
this
next week.
Radio.
It's about to go down.
We twerking.
Not only will we be talking about scandal next week.
Yes.
But
twerk off.
We
it's
love
to be
twerk
off. Oh, my God. I'm already excited. I'm already excited. Scandal and a twerk off.
Carrie Washington.
Can't get no better.
Huh? Coffee twerking.
Can't get no better.
Can't get no better.
And now that Niki twerking. Can twerk, that was amazing.
Was it?
That was amazing.
Well done, Niki.
Oh, God, Mark.
You just can't get into the aggressive twerking.
No. Lester, look, we've seen her try.
That, Mark.
We've seen, yes, we've seen.
No, they laughed at me.
We see.
I know, babe.
I mean, they laughed uncontrollably.
I know, but they.
My first attempt at twerking.
It was not pretty.
Resulted in.
It was not pretty.
But you
unending
weren't.
Ending laughter.
You weren't serious, though. I mean,
totally serious.
No.
I was fucking totally serious.
No.
It was almost
you
like
couldn't.
That time I did the cartwheel.
That's going to say the same thing, yeah.
Oh, my God.
And we know how that ended.
Cartwheel. Oh, God. We were coming out of a restaurant.
Okay.
She almost killed herself doing the
cartwheel. Fuck, do it.
Man, she almost killed herself.
I swear to God, man, here's how, wait, before you do it, here's how it went. In my mind, I felt like back when I was a teenager, I could fucking cartwheel. I could do the no hand, the roundup, everything. So we downtown across from Wolfgang Puck. And I'm like, right in front of the court building. And I'm like, I could do a cartwheel. And I had on flip-flops.
Motherfuck.
Which was the first wrong decision.
Did I do it? Did I do it? Did I do it?
Hey, look.
Yes, Mark, you did it. Well done.
I had dialed 9-1 on my phone. I was ready to push the other one to get this motherfucker Amala hit.
What was so funny, though, was you know how, like, when Gabrielle starts off? You know when Gabrielle starts off and it looks graceful? That's exactly how it looked. Like, oh, like she's going to do something. Oh, no. Oh, no. Big girl going down. Big girl going so down. Sad.
That shit the man was down situation.
I didn't even help myself.
Were you?
Man
I was
down.
Like, damn. Flip flop flew one way. The foot never even got in the air. Fucking flip flop flew off. But that was it.
When you were picturing yourself as you were younger, were you voluptuous also then?
I've always been chunky.
You should have heard her.
And so you handled your weight well when you were younger.
Yeah.
The way she was telling us. She had us convinced.
I was like, I can do it.
It's going down. Like, it's getting ready to go down.
I can do a cartwheel. I can do a cartwheel.
I couldn't do a cartwheel.
She couldn't do a cartwheel. She almost killed her goddamn self.
I couldn't do nothing like a cartwheel. It was more like a buggy.
It was more like a wheel.
I was on the side of the
curb. Heavy one of them buggies.
All right, y'all. It's time to go home.
Yeah.
Make sure you come out to Layla Lounge.
23rd.
Get your tickets now while they're hot.
Coffee's Lounge, 2632 Georgia Avenue. What y'all got going on?
Well, we got some parties. happy hour. So come on out.
Happy hour. What nights? What time?
Wednesday, Thursday, Friday.
Wednesday, Thursday, Friday from 6 until.
Come on, get a little drink on. Sip
drink
of
specials. Lots of fun and lots of coffee.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yes.
And we're going to have comedy soon.
Yes.
Yes. Comedy
Friday
soon
night.
And coffee.
Happy hour. Happy hour with Chuckles.
Yeah.
All right. It's been a wonderful show. And
a real
I'm
hoot.
Just super excited because I can twerk now.
Woo.
Yeah. Yeah.
And you look good doing it.
Okay, I'm so motivated.
She's
right
about
now,
to get a
like,
contest and everything.
Yeah,
now.
I'm gonna be all
so motivated.
Look at my twerk. Look at my twerk. Look at my twerk.
This is Just Jokes Radio. Michael,
peace.
Roshan,
coffee, peace.
Yeah. Last
pervert. Yeah.
Oh wait, before we go, Foster.
Why it's 10:01?
Okay, who is the Just Jokes Jackass of the week?
Real quick.
Lester.
Probably them two assholes that thought that they could just go nigga on those text messages.
Okay.
Okay.
The guy that decided he was going to cut his nuts off to get out of the marriage.
Mm.
DMX.
The guy with the filibuster that tried to get the Obamacare cut. Fuck that.
Asshole Ted from Texas.
Green eggs and ham.
The Republicans.
Yes.
The Republicans. I'm with the Republicans and the Tea Party. Just Jokes Jackass of the week.
Yes.
Whatever happens, just know that they are ridiculous.
Happy birthday,
and they
Robin.
Will go to any length.
I love you. Happy
this
birthday.
This is Just Jokes Radio.